Damas y caballeros, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President and CEO of the Hispanic Heritage Foundation, José Antonio Tierino.
Wow. Mira que linda es mi gente, huh? Bienvenido and welcome to the Hispanic Heritage Foundation's Hispanic Heritage Awards presented by Target, and happy Hispanic Heritage Month. On behalf of Target and all our sponsors and the Hispanic Heritage Foundation board, and the co-hosts and organizations, it's our great privilege to welcome you to the 29th Annual Hispanic Heritage Awards at the Warner Theater. In terms of history, in 1987, the Hispanic Heritage Awards were established by the White House to celebrate the creation of Hispanic Heritage Month in the United States. Rudy Becerra led that effort at the White House under the Reagan administration, and as an organization, we were co-founded by Elaine Dagan, who is also here tonight. A round of applause for Rudy and Elaine. We have shared so many inspirational moments on this stage over nearly three decades, and we will again tonight. And as we celebrate cultural pride, vision, and accomplishment, the embodied through our honorees. As a community, tenemos que estar unidos and be inclusive. I don't want to hear... I don't want to hear that someone isn't welcome because they don't speak a word of Spanish, or they don't speak a word of English, or because they're too dark-skinned and Afro-Latino, or too light-skinned, or because they're GLBT, or because they're from a particular country in Central or North America or anywhere around the globe, because they aren't of Hispanic descent, we still will bring you if you'll love and appreciate our culture so much that they need to be a part of our community. Even if you're not, you're still part of our community. Todos somos Latinos y vamos a ir para adelante con fuerza. Y sin frenos. So, my mom used to say that. Never had it been more important to demonstrate the tremendous value we offer this great country as real Americans. We are real Americans. Nobody should define us. We define ourselves. America needs the Latino community to move forward, and we need to be there ready to answer the call, as we always have over and over again throughout our history. As Latinos, we have always been prepared to serve and fill any gap America has with ganas. The needs of our great nation have shifted to technology, healthcare, finance, entrepreneurship, public service, education, science, media, and other fields. And we will once again come through. Hispanic Heritage Foundation works year-round to ensure we meet America's needs in the workforce with leadership, education, and public awareness through our award-winning mission and through our Latinos on Fast Track program, which is comprised of more than 100,000 vetted Latino leaders. As we like to say, get on the Fast Track. Speaking of Fast Track, I'd like to bring out an embodiment of our mission from the time he was on this stage as a National Youth Awardee to his work re-engage and re-energizing LOFT. As a student at Stanford and as a professional career, he has guided us into very exciting areas, which is huge gaping holes that we've been able to fill, especially in technology and finance. Here's our chair, Emmanuel Pleitas.
Just use the teleprompter. I've been using it. Thank you, Tony, and welcome, everyone. It's been an amazing journey to grow up in this organization and to work with a dedicated HHF board and staff has been a privilege. Please join us in congratulating the 2016 honorees. For technology, Tony Jimenez. Woo! For wellness, Massey Arias. Pause. Wait. Okay. For arts, Fania All-Stars. For literature, Juno Diaz. For legend, Angelica Maria. For business, George Herrera. For STEM, Dr. Diana Natalicio. For vision, J. Balvin. This year's Inspira awardee is Prince Royce.
I'll join you on this one.
And for leadership, Justice Sonia Sotomayor. Eso. We will also be entertained tonight, inspired, and made to dance. I know it might be tough, but get up. In our seats by talented Latino entertainers, Angelica Maria and her daughter, Angelica Vale, J Balvin, Prince Royce, and the Fania All-Stars. In addition, La Santa Cecilia, Eileen Perez, Jason Cerda, and Nicholas Rodriguez will light up the stage tonight.
We're also joined by our impressive list of sponsors. Our sponsors understand the value the Latino community provides, and we are very thankful for their support. For the fourth year in a row, Target is our presenting sponsor, and we are very grateful for their continued leadership. Our partnership with Target is much bigger than just a beautiful night in September. Laisha Ward and the Target team members all over the country work closely with us in ensuring our community is being served. Here to speak on Target's behalf is my good friend, Isaac Reyes.
Thank you and good evening, everyone. It's an honor to be here with so many Latino leaders, including my good friend, Tony, and everyone at the Hispanic Heritage Foundation. How about a big round of applause for Tony? At Target, we believe health and well-being is one of our greatest assets and one of our biggest challenges as parents, communities, and as a nation. Studies show that our children are part of a generation that's expected to have a shorter life expectancy than we are. That's just unacceptable. Thanks to leaders like all of you, we're doing something about it. Last fall, we hit a milestone of giving $1 billion to education. That's billion with a B. We're now leveraging that experience and are now extending our focus to wellness. We've integrated wellness across our business to help our guests, our team, and our communities eat better, be more active, and live healthier lives. One of tonight's honorees, the incredible Masi Arias, along with video blogger Dulce Candy, model Heidi De La Rosa, and the legendary Rita Moreno, starting a fantastic TV spot that celebrates health and beauty at any age. Let's take a look.
Sigo caminando, sigo riendo. Hago lo que quiera, muero en el intento. A nadie le importa lo que estoy haciendo. Lo único que importa es lo que está por dentro. Hey. Cuando te critiquen, tú solo di. Soy yo, soy, soy, soy yo.
Now that's what I call some serious Latina power. If we can just find a way to get it Justice Sotomayor in there next time. That, That great ad reminds me of my personal hero, the strong Latina that raised me as a single mom, juggling three jobs, always sacrificing for me and my sisters. So thank you, Mom, for being a strong Latina and for showing me how to raise my daughter, Sophia, to be like you and like so many of you in this room. I'm gonna encourage Sophia to be like all of you, to raise her voice until she is heard, to stand up, to act up, and to live up to her dreams, and to always remember to celebrate all of her accomplishments, big and small. To Masi, and to all of those who are inspiring us and our children to live better, healthier lives, we thank you. And on behalf of everyone at Target, thank you and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you, Isaac. And now please join us in welcoming our medallion level sponsors and please clap as we call them out. Wyndham Worldwide, the official hospitality partner of the Hispanic Heritage Awards and the Hispanic Heritage Foundation. Southwest Airlines, the official airline of the Hispanic Heritage Awards. Aetna, official health insurance partner of the Hispanic Heritage Awards. Hershey's, Shorts TV, AARP, Exxon Mobil, ATI Systems Incorporated, Zantec, Proforce, and Oak Grove Technologies. Another round.
Tonight's program will be broadcast on PBS on September 30th at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Check your local listings. And we are grateful to our broadcast partner, PBS, who will make it possible for all of America to celebrate along with us here in this theater. Joining us from PBS is PBS Senior Vice President, HHF Board Member, and a great friend, Juan Sepulveda.
Thanks, Tony. 3 years ago, when I had just started at PBS, Tony and I talked about how good it would be for us to work together and to bring the Hispanic Heritage Awards to PBS. After all, PBS is committed to being America's storyteller, to sharing the rich diversity of our nation's stories. For the past 29 years, the Hispanic Heritage Foundation has done the same. They've opened our country's eyes to the incredible contributions Latinos have made to the United States, from artists to athletes to educators and community leaders, and tonight, a Supreme Court justice. All Americans should have a front row seat to these accomplishments. And that's why PBS and its member stations are honored to be broadcasting the Hispanic Heritage Awards for the third year in a row. Please join me in thanking Tony and his team for bringing the best of our community to the nation. And make sure to watch the Hispanic Heritage Awards next Friday at 10 o'clock. Thanks.
Do you remember when I started this and I said, que linda es mi gente? Well, there's a really special friend of mine, an HHF's, who's in the business of making people feel beautiful. And how noble is that? He's been supporting this program for 16 years as our official beauty partner, and he does it pro bono out of the kindness of his big, huge heart. I don't know how he contained it in his little body because he's very flaquito. In fact, anyone that you see in Washington, D.C. walking around that has a glow was probably just at Karma Beauty Lounge by Erwin Gomez. From the First Lady to Oprah Winfrey to J-Lo to my gorgeous wife, Dinah, they all go to Erwin Gomez. Please join us in just thanking him because we've never done it officially. A part of the family of Hispanic Heritage Awards, Erwin Gomez.
I'm really honored to be here right now. And I just want to say thank you for the Hispanic Heritage Foundation and Tony and especially to my staff. I would not be able to do this without them. And of course, my friends. And you guys all look beautiful. Thank you.
I think he parachuted in because he still has that strap. For the past 2 years, I've been very involved with the unaccompanied minor crisis, which continues today. These young people are fleeing among the most dangerous regions in the world simply to stay alive. I went to the Rio Grande Valley with a group of advocates, including America Ferreira and many others that are here in this audience tonight. And we worked with a heroic woman named Sister Norma. Since then, we have continued the work domestically with Imagination Stage Oyeme program, as well as home countries with Catholic Relief Services. CRS is working with youth in El Salvador, Honduras, and Guatemala to provide hope and opportunity to avoid that dangerous journey that they're trying to get to safety. Please watch this very short video about some of the work we're doing with.
Ser joven en El Salvador es un riesgo. Hay mucha inseguridad.
Mi vida no estaba yendo a ningún lado.
Todo parecía estar en contra de nosotras.
Si uno es joven y pobre en esta región, puede ser víctima tanto de las pandillas como de la policía. Equivocarse puede ser mortal.
Queríamos irnos. Mi mamá soñaba con una vida mejor para nosotros.
Jóvenes Constructores me brindó un lugar seguro.
Mi familia y mi comunidad ven al nuevo yo y me apoyan.
Nuestra empresa cree en estos jóvenes. Por esa razón, nosotros creamos relaciones personales con ellos y también invertimos en su desarrollo personal y profesional.
Su donación, su voz en el Congreso, su experticia puede ayudar a desencadenar la energía de los jóvenes para cambiar la dirección de sus vidas.
Cuando usted cree en las juventudes, cree en El Salvador.
Únete para el cambio. Únete con la gente que está cambiando El Salvador.
And now, for tonight's blessing, is Father David Garcia from Catholic Relief Services.
Let's just bow our heads in prayer. Vamos a inclinar las cabezas para recibir la bendición de Dios. Oh God, we've gathered here tonight to honor the many contributions that our talented brethren have made to our great nation. They have not forgotten where they came from. As a priest of the Archdiocese of San Antonio and a staff member of Catholic Relief Services, Lord, we pray on this festive night for the lives of young people who are threatened every day in Central America. Families forced to leave their homes on a perilous journey north because of violence and poverty. We pray also, God Almighty, for the youth who remain, that they may find safe spaces and afford the opportunity to study, find a job, and thrive. Youth like Lily here from El Salvador. She's risen out of fear and despair. Bless her and others like her who are agents of change amidst chaos. Oh God, give us the courage that Lily has so we may be strong advocates for what is right in this pivotal election year, and help us give this country the promise of a better tomorrow, filled with a fruitful future where all children, native-born, immigrant, and refugee, can stand here and be thanked for their God-given gifts. All this we ask in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Father. Our next guest is the CEO of Shorts HD, a cable TV channel showing the world's best short movies and bringing Oscar-nominated short films to the movie theaters across America each year. Please welcome Carter Pilcher, as well as writer-director Carmen Marron, the governor of the Academy of Motion Pictures, John Bloom.
Thank you, Tony. Short movies are the future of film. Cutting-edge filmmakers, but also big Hispanic names like Cuarón and Iñárritu, who make shorts almost as often as they make features. Earlier this year, the Oscars So White movement brought much needed attention to the lack of diversity in film. At Shorts HD, we believe we're part of the solution, and short films are the pipeline to diversity. So we partnered with HHF to start changing Hollywood, one story at a time. Together, we established the annual Hispanic Heritage Short Film Award to provide a focal point for Latino film talent and to ensure their films are seen, awarded, and make it successfully into the Academy Awards process. We launched the search for this year's best Hispanic films and filmmakers in June. The response was outrageous. We hoped to receive at least 50 films. 50. We received nearly 1,000. Our team was overwhelmed. The films were spectacular. We've issued broadcast contracts to almost 130 films by Hispanic filmmakers. On Shorts TV this month, we're showing 40 hours of Hispanic short films. So, to select today's five nominees, we're joined by a distinguished jury of writer-director Carmen Morón and John Bloom, a governor of the Academy of Motion Pictures, and Antonio Tiarino, and myself. The nominees, who are offered the chance to qualify their films for Academy consideration, will be part of a mentorship program with industry experts and a $10,000 prize. The nominees are Eric Castrillon for Blast Beat, Francisco Larita for Mediation, Marcelo Mitnick for In the Clouds, and Carlos Mendoza Guillen for Happy Birthday, and Santiago Paladinas for The Fair. But the films, honestly, were too good. Our jury deadlocked over the winner in a tie ballot, and so today, we don't have one winner. We have two. We increased the prize money to $7,500 for each film, a total of $15,000. And we have two winners, and they are Marcelo Mitnick for In the Clouds and Santiago Paladinas for The Fair. Before we hear from our winners, though, let's get a quick glimpse at how truly amazing these filmmakers are.
Entonces, hoy en día, ¿cuántas personas por semana compran un anillo de compromiso?
No sé, dos o tres, digamos.
No, pero digo argentinos.
Ah, uno. Al mes. Con suerte.
Creo que me lo va a proponer.
¿Como las películas yankees?
People really do that?
Yeah.
Like, in real life? Women in Argentina don't like it.
Es horrible. Es que tus viejos van a poner una dote también.
Sí, una cabra y dos campos.
Bueno, por saber lo que tiene en mente. Fue tan misterioso.
Plane? You mean, you know, the kind that carries banners and stuff.
Let's go! Come on! Move! Okay. Are you deaf? Get out!
Come on. Apúrate.
Corren, caminen.
Welcome
here! You're gonna take the girl to Magdalena today. It's time. I told you to come.
Aquí es diferente. Reglas. Tienes que tener familia que pague por ti. Es la única manera.
She asked why she's here. I said nothing.
Look at her!
Wait till Valentine finds out about
this movie. I see you. And I see myself when I was young.
This is truly an honor. Thank you very much. Thank you, the Hispanic Heritage Foundation, and thank you, Shorts HD. I'm very honored to be representing Ecuador and all Latinos in the world. Thank you.
Thank you so much to the Hispanic Heritage Foundation and Shorts HD for this incredible recognition. Any of the fellow filmmakers who were nominated or the 1,000 entries who were submitted are equally deserving of these films, and you ought to watch them, because the more we watch Latino content, the more that it will get produced and distributed. And I want to thank my family and friends for walking with me through this insane journey, the amazing cast and crew, and my production team, Paula and Alex Cito, Fede Posternak, my dear friend Paula Manzanito Schmidt, and my partner in life and crime, Dave Kajanek, without whom nothing would have been possible. And last but not least, I want to thank the Foundation for letting me stand on the same stage as one of my heroes, a Supreme Court Justice Sonia Sotomayor.
Thank you, Carter, and congratulations to the talented filmmakers that once again are proof that there is no shortage of talent in the Latino community. Finally, thank you to Tony and the hardworking staff of the Hispanic Heritage Foundation and the extended team and volunteers for making tonight a reality. A big thank you to our executive producer, Nouveau Productions, for making sure you are inspired and entertained tonight. Thank you for joining us, and please enjoy the evening. Thank you.
From the historic Warner Theater in Washington, D.C., it's the 29th Annual Hispanic Heritage Awards. Tonight, the Hispanic Heritage Awards celebrates La Novia de Mexico, Angélica María, award-winning author Juno Díaz, visionary Grammy Award-winning vocalist J Balvin, business leader George Herrera, revolutionary ensemble the Fania All-Stars, tech innovator Tony Jimenez, health and wellness leader Masi Arias, 18-time Billboard Latin Music Award winner Prince Royce, university president Dr. Diana Natalicio, and associate justice of the Supreme Court of the United States, Justice Sonia Sotomayor. With performances and special appearances by Aileen Perez, Angélica Valle, La Santa Cecilia, Julissa Arce, Angélica María, Nicholas Rodriguez, Alex Meneses, Prince Royce, and many more. Tonight's ceremony will be hosted by actors Elizabeth Rodriguez and Berto Colón. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for our national anthem.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, from the hit television show Orange is the New Black, please welcome your hosts for this evening, Elizabeth Rodriguez and Berto Colon.
Good evening and buenas noches.
Buenas noches, buenas noches. Viene mi gente, griten, griten.
What an honor it is for us to be with you hosting the 29th Annual Hispanic Heritage Awards.
This is going to be an incredible night
for
all of us. We're gathered here. We're in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., and we're going to celebrate the contributions of Hispanic Americans in numerous fields, from wellness to arts, from science to leadership.
But before we go any further, let's take a minute to acknowledge that beautiful rendition of our national anthem, sung by the celebrated soprano, Aileen Perez. Diva.
So all of our honorees are basically have one thing in common. They are creme de la creme. They are each at the very, very top of their respective professions. And they have shown the Latino community and the whole world that with dedication comes a lasting impact, not only in our present, but also in our future. So, mi gente, prepárense, because tonight we are going to celebrate these special individuals and their very, very significant achievements.
So let's get started.
Vamos para encima.
Our first honoree has been nicknamed Mexico's sweetheart and transitioned gracefully from child star to teen idol to a true living legend. Let's take a look now at the legendary career of Angélica María.
Recording over 60 albums in the span of her career and starring in thousands of international tours, films, plays, and telenovelas, La Novia de México, Angélica María is one of Latino culture's finest and most eclectic performing artists. Whisked away to stardom at the age of 6, she began her career in film with Mi Esposo y La Otra, winning a Mexican Film Academy Award for her breakout performance. At 18, she broke into her singing career with the song Eddie Eddie, later joining famous labels such as RCA, CBS, and Universal Music. Her most iconic contribution to Latin music came with the creation of Balada Ranchera with international recording artist Juan Gabriel. A recent Lifetime Achievement Award recipient by the Latin Grammys and a star bearer on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, Angélica María remains a powerful and internationally respected voice for Latin American culture.
AARP is committed to improving the quality of life of Hispanics 50 plus in what matters the most, health, finance, and love. We're proud to share the Hispanic Heritage Foundation's mission of empowering Latinos to achieve their goals at any age, because we know that as Latinos, juntos es posible. It is an honor for AARP to present the Legend Award to an outstanding Latina, the iconic Angélica María, who has been an inspiration for multiple generations. Felicidades.
To present the Hispanic Heritage Legend Award, please welcome to the stage three very special people. Joining His Excellency, the Ambassador of Mexico to the United States, Carlos M. Sada, are Angélica's daughter and granddaughter, Angélica Valle, a celebrated artist in her own right, and her daughter, Angélica Maciel.
Angélica María has been Mexico's brightest star for decades. I, along with the rest of the Latino community, have watched Angélica build a legacy that will last for centuries to come.
Growing up as Angélica María's daughter meant learning every day from a courageous and a spectacular role model. Yeah, sorry, my English, like Celia said, is not very good looking. Mother, you surprise me, you make me proud to be your daughter, and you continue to show my own daughter what it means to be a Latina. Woo!
It is our honor to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Latin Award to La Novia de Mexico.
And my mother, Angélica María. Muchas gracias, señor embajador. Gracias, hijita. Gracias, mi niña dorada. Gracias a ustedes por esta noche maravillosa para mí. Thank you. Good evening. And I am humbled by this recognition, and I accept this honor on behalf of my people, Latinos, who, like me, have come to this country to work hard from the fields to a stage like this. With pride, dignity, and respect. Thank you very, very much for this. I'm very proud. Thank you. Y quiero pedirle a los latinos que voten, que vayan a votar. Este es el momento de unirnos. Hay que votar para que nos respeten. ¡Viva México! ¡Vivan los latinos! ¡Vivan los Estados Unidos! ¡Gracias!
Often referred to as a creative hybrid of Latin culture, rock, and world music, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Grammy Award-winning musical group, La Santa Cecilia.
Conoces bien si supones que aquí me quedaré. Oye, yo me largaré una noche y te sorprenderá. Dime, ¿qué fue del Superman? Solo dime, mi hombre, ¿dónde está?
Guys, let's give it one more time for La Santa Cecilia. Emily Dickinson once said that nothing in the world has as much power as a word. It's my holy grail, and I couldn't agree with her more. Words have the ability to transform our imagination. They can take us places. We can meet new people. We can feel their sorrows. We can learn their deepest desires. When a writer has the gift, that's an extraordinary gift. Any writer that can do that, well, that's just amazing. So let's take a look at one such writer.
After immigrating from the Dominican Republic, Juno Diaz attended his first day of school in the United States without knowing a single word of English. Despite these odds, Diaz persevered and was eventually accepted to Rutgers University, graduating with a bachelor's degree in history and literature, and later received his MFA in creative writing from Cornell University. His commencement led to the publication of two collections of short stories, Drown and This Is How You Lose Her, both national bestsellers and recipients of critical acclaim. But it was the publication of his novel, The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde, that won him the Pulitzer Prize for Fiction in 2008 and solidified his position as one of the best writers of the 21st century. A MacArthur Fellow and recipient of the Guggenheim Fellowship, Juno Diaz continues his work teaching creative writing at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology and remains a powerful voice in the fight for immigration rights in the United States and the Dominican Republic.
If you know Southwest, then you know that we're more than just an airline. Whether in the air or on the ground, we share our heart by connecting people and championing communities. Tonight, we celebrate the strength and dedication of Latinos whose hard work, cultural pride, and commitment to community has helped shape our society. Each of you has laid the foundation before us and are blazing trails right before our eyes. We believe a community is more than a place. It's at the heart of what brings us together. On behalf of Southwest Airlines and its more than 50,000 employees, congratulations.
And now to present the Literature Award, please welcome emerging leading voice in the fight for immigrant rights and the author of My Underground American Dream, Julissa Arce, as well as playwright and actor from HBO's Looking and Netflix Easy, mi pana fuerte, Raúl Castillo.
Good evening. It takes a powerful voice to spark real change. And no one's voice is as powerful today as our next honorees. Through his incredible stories and his down-to-earth dialogue, Juno Diaz has given the world a true depiction of Latino culture.
As a playwright and a storyteller, I am continuously amazed at how Juno Diaz astounds readers and writers like myself with his authenticity and tenacity. I brought my copy of This Is How You Lose Her. I'm hoping to get it signed backstage. There is no doubt in our minds that all of us are standing in front of an American literary icon.
It is our honor to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Literature Award to Juno Diaz. Please welcome her.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's a tremendous honor. And of course, Angelica, she let us know. Get our asses out to vote, right? She let us know. Let us know. Yeah. This is a tremendous honor. I wanted to thank the Hispanic Heritage Foundation for this honor, for making this evening possible, for all the folks who put this together. You did an enormous amount of anonymous, invisible work. I want to acknowledge that. And I wanted to just, dedicate my award to this award. Oh, and also my fellow honorees. Really, when I was told that I was going to be up with J Balvin and Justice Sotomayor, I was like, my ass is there. I'm coming. I'll even buy a tux, you know? So, tremendous honor. So I'm gonna read very quickly and short, because otherwise I'll mess it up. I wish to dedicate this award to my comunidad Latina, to my comunidad Caribeña, wherever you may be, especially those of us who are immigrants, and especially our undocumented youth, our community is the paragon of strength, of resilience, of creativity. We are the only superpower this country will ever know. We survived everything this world threw at us. We survived wars, survived dictators, survived torturers and violence, endless violence and borders, all the damn borders, and the loneliness of the newcomers in a new land. We survived the loss of home, the loss of family, the loss of language. We survived no one knowing how to say our names. We survived our parents' suffering and our parents' silence and their scars that speak louder than the bombs that put them there. We survived our confusions about who we are in a country that only seems to speak black and white. And we survived not speaking English, survived not speaking Spanish, survived not speaking. And all that damn paperwork, we survived that too. And we survived the ingratitude of the nation where we settled, the nation we helped build and for whom we continuously die. And we survived the infinite heartbreak that is the true story of immigration. And we survived the agony of not knowing how to bear witness to that story and to ourselves. And we survived the hate that never seems to die, the hate that pretends to be patriotism, that pretends to be security, that pretends to be leadership, a hate that won't listen to reason, to morality, to compassion. We survived it all. We survived it all. We are the people who survive. We survived everything, surviving even the surviving, which is the hardest survival of all. And in the middle of that surviving, some of us even learned how to live. Our story is an epic, a saga, an odyssey. We crossed continents and oceans, and every time there was no way, we made a way. We are the children of bridges, bridges made from our backs, our tears, our sacrifices, and from all the ones who never made it across with us. We in the Latino community are among the greatest heroes our world has known. And yet, despite all we do and all we are, we find ourselves attacked and demonized and endangered, not just in this country, all over the world. Communities like ours are under assault. And this is why we cannot just survive or live. We have to fight for justice. We have to fight for equality. All of us must be free. All of us must be free. All of us must be free or none. Thank you.
Wow. Is this not amazing so far? Wow, to freedom. A visionary is defined as someone who is inspired, imaginative, creative, inventive, ingenious, enterprising, and innovative. Let's take a look at why our next honoree is all of these things and so much more.
Lauded for revitalizing reggaeton with his chart-topping hits, J Balvin began his career working tirelessly to learn English in the United States. After saving funds through years of manual labor, Balvin eventually returned home to Colombia to allow his people to carry him to fame. His record-shattering album La Familia cemented his place as an international recording star, with his tracks 6 AM and Ay Vamos topping charts in the US, Latin America, and Europe. Balvin has been nominated for over a dozen Billboard Latin Music Awards, 5 Latin Grammy Awards, and has taken home the Best Urban Song Latin Grammy. Balvin continues to excel in his profession, collaborating with famous recording artists such as Pharrell Williams, Juan Gabriel, Daddy Yankee, and Juanes. His remix of Justin Bieber's single Sorry became an international hit. Young, ambitious, and the pride of Colombia, J Balvin continues to aim high, spread reggaeton to an international community, and share his artistic brilliance.
At Hershey, we focus attention on creating an innovation everywhere mindset across the organization by bringing together people with diversity of thought, interest, skills, and experience. We have more effective collaboration and better results, allowing each of us to do our best work. Jose, felicitaciones en este merecido logro. Congratulations on your remarkable achievement.
To present the Hispanic Heritage Vision Award is an incredible artist. Please welcome Latin Billboard Award nominee for Artist of the Year, and last year's Hispanic Heritage Inspira awardee, Becky G.
What's up, everybody? I think you guys can be a little louder than that. So what's up, everybody? It's such a pleasure to be here tonight with you all. I am truly inspired by the work of all of the incredible honorees that we are honoring tonight. And I'm also very happy to be able to present the Vision Award to one of my very dear friends. Each year, he continues to show the world that music serves as a way to connect all of us. His respect for his craft and his commitment to artistic excellence has propelled him to incredible heights. And I think we can't wait to see what he does next. Please welcome the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Vision Award recipient, my boy, J Balvin.
Finally, I got my first bling bling. Well, Colombia, claro, of course. You know, I think being Latino is not a coincidence. I think it's a blessing. And I'm really grateful with every, todos ustedes, because, you know, it's been a new concept of reggaeton showing the world that we're different. We're not what we used to do anymore. Me da yo, mijo, Medellín. Y lo que quiero realmente, can I speak in Spanish? I think it's better. Thank you, gracias. Lo que quiero realmente es que la gente siga sus sueños. Que recuerdo que antes, cuando llegué a Estados Unidos y trabajé pintando casas ilegalmente, ahora pinto mis sueños legalmente. Y vale la pena soñar, vale la pena los sacrificios. Ningún sueño se hace realidad sin sacrificio. Invito a toda la juventud que me escucha y a los que también me escuchan, que no les gusta el reggaetón, pero les gusta y les queda algo bien de pronto, se inspiren a echar siempre para adelante, a luchar por sus sueños y que salgan a votar para que no les suene la trompeta a cualquiera por ahí. Así que muchas gracias. Dios los bendiga.
Recently named one of Billboard's top 10 new artists to look out for, please welcome Latin recording artist Jason Cerda.
Jay Cerda. Escalofrío cuando entra la tentación que está en su boca. Me estás tentando, lo estás bailando, me estás provocando. Quiero un poco más, más, más. Oh, oh, baby, you know you drive me crazy. Your body's so amazing. Quiero un poco más, más, más. Un poco más, más, más. Un poco más, más, más. Un poquito más, más, más. Dame un poco más, más, más. Un poco más, más, más. Un poco más, más, más. Un poquito más, más. que tú me tiras, a mí vuelves loco. Cuando estás al lado mío, este momento es tuyo y mío, y eso es lo que importa. Me estás tentando cuando estás bailando, me vives provocando y quiero un poco más, más, más. Oh, baby, you know you drive me crazy, your body's so amazing. Quiero un poco más, 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 un poco más, 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 un poco más, 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 un poquito más, 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 da un poco más, 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 un poco más, 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 un poco más, 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 un poquito más, más, más.
Come on, DC, let's go.
You're better for me, now I said so they go outside. My vida, you and me, the hard kid, but just not with me. Like you're better for me.
Washington, D.C. You having a good time tonight? Let's go! I go by the name of Jay. Sip, sip, duck.
Muchas gracias, señoras y señores. Once again, I go by the name of Jason Serta. Thank you for having me tonight. Que Dios lo bendiga.
Again now. The most accomplished in business will tell you that a significant amount of sacrifice and hard work must be exercised to achieve success. This next honoree did not have $1 million loan from his father. I had to throw that in there somehow. But what he did have is something called determination, you know, perseverance, and grit to really become a leader in the business community. So please, let's take a look.
With over 30 years of experience in economic and business development and a strident passion for diversity and inclusion in the workplace, George Herrera began his career as president of David J. Burgos & Associates, evolving the company into the largest Hispanic women-owned management and consulting firm in America. He continued his advocacy for Hispanic businesses as president and CEO of the U.S. Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and in 1999 brought Hispanic businesses to television with the creation of the first ever nationally syndicated Hispanic content English language show, Hispanics Today, viewed by more than 30 million Americans weekly. A fellow of the Wharton Society of Fellows from the University of Pennsylvania's Wharton School of Business, Herrera continues to fight for the nation's fastest growing sector of the small business community, a champion for the incredible potential of minorities in the United States.
Wyndham Worldwide is proud to have George Herrera on our board of directors. At Wyndham, we're all about sending the everyday traveler on trips of their dreams, allowing people to travel the way they want to travel. Well, George has spent his entire life the same way, inspiring people, raising people up, allowing them to go beyond their dreams. So on behalf of Wyndham Worldwide, George, congratulations on this terrific honor. And also to the other honorees, congratulations.
And now to present the Hispanic Heritage Business Award. He is a star of the stage and the screen. and she is the head of the U.S. Small Business Administration and a member of President Obama's cabinet. Please welcome Nicolas Rodriguez and the Honorable Maria Contreras Sweet.
You know, one of the most interesting parts of playing different characters is that most of the time you get to take a look inside and see what makes the person tick. And the more that I learn about George Herrera and the incredible work that he has done as a businessman, the more respect I have for his work and for him as an individual.
As an immigrant from Mexico, and now a member of President Obama's cabinet, I am so proud to serve as a champion for small businesses, for entrepreneurs, for makers, innovators, and dreamers. In fact, I know firsthand what a shining example George Herrera has become. He is our nation's small business leader. He's an exceptional person from whom others all want to learn. He is simply the best of the best. It is a great pleasure tonight to present to him the Hispanic Heritage Business Award. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome up Mr. George Herrera.
Buenas noches. Buenas noches. Yeah. I want to thank Antonio and the Hispanic Heritage Foundation for this prestigious honor. And congratulations to all of the evening's honorees. What a stellar group of Hispanic achievers and leaders. But I must tell you that I am extremely humbled to be standing here this evening. I would never have imagined that my journey, which began in Bedford-Stuyvesant, Brooklyn, New York, over 60 years ago, would land me on the stage of the Warner Theater in the nation's capital in the year 2016. I am forever blessed and extremely grateful. But you see, ladies and gentlemen, I need to share this award with my mentor and my best friend in life, my sister Elizabeth. You see, I worked for Liz for 22 years, and I'm still standing here to talk about it. You see, Liz taught me the meaning of success at a very young age. She taught me to surround myself with people who were masters at what they did and who would challenge me and push me to excellence. And she was so right. Liz, thank you. Thank you for believing in me and for being the best boss, mentor, and sister that I can ever have. I love you, sis. I have also had the honor of serving as president and CEO of the United States Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, serve on the board of directors of a Fortune 50 company, and so honored to currently serve on the board of directors of Wyndham Worldwide Corporation. And for me, it truly has been a great journey for this son born to a Boricua mother and a Chilean father. I'm the only Boricua Chileno I've ever met in my life. So. If there's one in the audience, I want to meet you tonight. Pero yo estoy viejito, and it's time for me to move on. So to the new generation of Latino and Latina leaders, many of you are here in the audience this evening. It's your time. It's your time to step up. Because you could not be in a better place, at a better time, in the greatest country in the whole world. You see, America is yearning for you. America is yearning for you. It is starved for your authenticity, and it is hungry for your originality. However, as Latinos and Latinas who come from different walks of Hispanic culture, you know damn sure that we're gonna be challenged every day just because of who we are. But who we are leaders and achievers with talent, perseverance, determination, and ambition that gives you all the power to go as far as you can and live the dreams that you choose to live. Do not give in to this country and let the country set your measure of what is great. Let the country set your standards. And do not forget those that have come before you. You see, we as a people drink deeply from the wells of freedom and liberty that we did not dig. We eat lavishly from the banquet tables prepared by the loving hands of our ancestors who could scarcely imagine our existence, but we owe it to them. This is that love. That's why we celebrate Hispanic heritage. So as you travel through your life journey, never forget that you're part of a Latino community. Never forget that you're part of a nation. But more importantly, don't ever, ever forget that you're part of a human family. And remember, reputation is what someone else thinks of you. But character is what will ultimately define who you really are. Muchísimas gracias y que Dios lo bendiga.
Once again, please welcome to the stage Angélica María.
Hello again. Oh, I love you more. Thank you. A few weeks ago, Mexico lost a great composer and singer, our Juan Gabriel. And I want to sing now one of his beautiful songs. Please, maestro. Tú sigues siendo el mismo. I recorded it with mariachi, but with this orchestra, wow.
Que hace mucho que dejé yo de quererte y pensar que algún día juré amarte hasta la muerte, pero ahora me arrepiento de haber perdido el tiempo. También que te he olvidado.
Sigues siendo el mismo. La, 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 la.
a mariachi I had tonight. No sé exactamente qué pasó, que todo de repente ya cambió en nuestro diariamente. Termino. ¿A dónde va nuestro amor? Si cada día se va muriendo la flor de tu alegría, ¿a dónde va nuestro amor? Vestimos de altivez, queremos ser felices y reñimos 30 veces cada mes. ¿A dónde va nuestro amor? Si cada día en nuestro cielo hay un sol en agonía, ¿a dónde va nuestro amor? Yo me pregunto y no me sé contestar por cobardía. ¿A dónde va?
I had to change. Okay, we have so much more, so exciting. When a record label decided to form a musical act featuring some of its most recognizable artists, it catapulted, easy for me to say, the careers of more than 40 artists over the course of almost 50 years. Let's take a look at this year's Arts Award honoree.
Fania All-Stars began their journey over 40 years ago when executives at Fania Records brought together salsa's top recording artists to form an international performing sensation, an ensemble including Hispanic legends such as Celia Cruz, Willy Colon, Hector Lavoe, and El Niño Bonito de la Salsa, Ismael Miranda. Fania All-Stars revolutionized salsa music in the 1970s with sellout performances at Yankee Stadium and Madison Square Garden, and international performances in Puerto Rico, England, Cuba, Panama, Japan, and the 80,000-seat Stadio du Hai Stadium in what is now the Democratic Republic of Congo. The Fania All-Stars Ensemble spreads salsa music across continents. Their recording live at Yankee Stadium is included in the U.S. Library of Congress's National Recording Registry as a recording that is culturally important to the United States. Hailed for their passionate mission to bring salsa into the international spotlight, Fania Hispania All-Stars created a Latino cultural renaissance still felt decades later.
At Aetna, we have a deep appreciation for the many contributions of Latino leaders across the country. We applaud their achievements this evening and join in celebrating them as role models, especially for our young people. Through the activities of the Aetna Foundation, we work with committed nonprofit partners to create a healthier world for children and families. Congratulations to the Fania All-Stars and all the honorees. We look forward to working with you to create more healthy days in the future.
To present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Arts Award, Grammy and Billboard nominated Latin music superstar, Frankie Negron. And wait, calmate. And celebrated soprano, Aileen Perez.
Good evening. If I were to make my own biographical film, the soundtrack of my life, or should I say, the salsa soundtrack of my life, it would be filled with the extraordinary musicians of Fania All-Stars throughout the years. Tito Puente, Celia Cruz, Willy Colon, Richie Ray, Bobby Cruz, Nicky Marrero, y Ismael Miranda. The list goes on and on.
And although I'm known as an opera singer, I'm a Latina and an artist, and any artist can feel the unique rhythm and beat of salsa music, the music that has no barriers. And you know, it just wanna makes you move too. But who better to understand this than our legendary award recipients?
It's such an honor for us to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Awards to La Fania All-Stars.
Muy buenas noches. Qué privilegio estar aquí con ustedes hoy. Pues tengo varios amigos que están con nosotros, el Nicky Marrero, timbalero de las Estrellas de Fania, y el señor Richie Ray. Yeah. Para mí ha sido un viaje tremendo porque yo llegué aquí a los 4 años de Puerto Rico. Y yeah. Y como Richie, como Nicky, somos de Puerto Rico y llegamos aquí a una temprana edad y yo creo que nos vino bien porque nosotros nos criamos en un barrio donde en realidad no pensamos que teníamos oportunidad de nada. Pero gracias a Dios que pudimos encontrar algo que hacer, que fue la música. Y gracias a Dios que conseguimos un maestro como el señor Johnny Pacheco, que nos echó hacia adelante, y el señor Jerry Masucci, que abrió una compañía y gastó mucho dinero con nosotros y nos hizo que nosotros pudiéramos echar hacia adelante. Yo le doy gracias a ustedes por esta oportunidad que nos brindan, por este premio. Le doy gracias por estos 48 años que llevo en la música, que han sido un privilegio grande porque le he podido servir a la comunidad hispana con mi voz, que es lo único que tengo, y Richie con su piano y Nicky con su timbal. Así que en nombre de las Estrellas de Fania, yeah. Así que en medio de las Estrellas, por medio de este servidor, para todos los compañeros de la Fania que están en el cielo y para el señor Gianni Pacheco, que no pudo venir esta noche, está en su casa un poco enfermo, le dedicamos este premio a él y a toda la gente latina que se encuentra aquí esta noche. Que Dios les bendiga mucho.
One more time for Fania All-Stars, please. Our next award goes to an individual or a company that has excelled in the field of technology. People, do your research, because I did. And I have to confess, after learning of the achievements of this amazing individual, technology es el frosting on the cake. Let's take a moment to learn more about him.
Known today as one of America's most innovative entrepreneurs, Tony Jimenez's journey began as a decorated veteran of the U.S. Army. Following his service, Jimenez received multiple degrees in acquisition, computer and information systems, and business management, leading him to the role of program manager for the U.S. Army's business enterprise systems. After transitioning into the private sector, Jimenez soon envisioned a technology business centered around the principles of diversity, hard work, and superior customer service. Opening multiple mortgages and sacrificing his own retirement savings, Jimenez created an IT and cloud-based solutions company that became one of the top Hispanic-owned businesses in the nation. A recent recipient of a patent for his cloud appliance, Tony Jimenez rightfully calls himself a living example of the American dream, whose love for technology and desire to contribute to society make him a top leader in his industry and one of the most influential Hispanics in the nation.
So to present the Technology Award, please welcome Marine combat veteran, currently starring in the primetime hit series Gotham, my boy J.W. Cortez, and the Academy Award nominated film producer Moctezuma Esparza.
As a retired Army officer and decorated combat veteran with more than 24 years of active military service, Tony Jimenez could have taken a different path post-military, but he didn't. He had a determination and a passion that defined his next chapter in ways he couldn't have imagined.
Tony is an astounding person that we really don't appreciate how important his contributions are to every single person in the United States. He has 11 patents, inventions to his name, with seven more in the pipeline. The intellectual concepts behind the cloud computing that all of us rely on is his intellectual creation. Tony is someone who has a tremendous heart, and he gets things done.
Tony's incredible work has received a number of, It is now our great honor to add another title to his distinction, and we couldn't be more proud of him. Please welcome the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Technology Award recipient, Mr. Tony Jimenez.
You know, you rehearse your speech, you do it 1,000 times in your head, you're scared to death you're going to miss some points, and then you get up here and, wow. Tony, the Hispanic Heritage Foundation, thank you very much. This is truly an incredible, humbling honor, especially when you look at the list of amazing people who are receiving this award tonight and those who have received it in the past. In fact, just last year, I sat right there, just blown away by the amazing things that people in our community have done and are doing, and now I'm up here. In a word, wow. 30 years ago, when I embarked upon this journey in technology, had someone told me that technology would help to pave my road to success, I wouldn't have believed them, yet here I am. But the truth is, even as important as technology has been, education has actually been the key for me. My parents instilled the love of learning in me. My teachers took the time to work with me. And even though my family could not afford to send me to college, I found a way not only to go to college, to get a bachelor's degree, and I even went on to get two masters, including a master's in computers and resource management. The amazing thing was, I was told at least a dozen times that I was not college material. So who would have ever thought that my parents, who never graduated high school, would have figured out that education is the key? On behalf of my wonderful wife, Lily, mis hijos, my children, my mother, Cecile, who unfortunately could not be here today, our many valued employees at Microtech, our good friends, nuestra gran familia, our community, and most of all, God, who makes all things possible. I accept this award with the highest level of humility and appreciation. If my father were here, he would be so proud, but I know he's looking down and sharing this moment with me.
Please welcome back Vision Award honoree, J Balvin.
Who love me? You love me? I love you too. The first time you see a reggaetonero with a guitar, right? And bed.
Sabes que no quiero perderte, tú sabes que este amor es tan fuerte, era mi deber lo de los dos. Yeah, yeah. Es que esta noche ya saldré a buscarte, cuando la luna deje de mirarte y me entregues todo tu cuerpo. Entiende que yo sigo extrañándote a cada instante, en todo momento. Entiende que yo sigo extrañándote a cada instante, en todo momento. Deja que te cuente, no sales de mi mente, siempre presente, yo estoy pendiente a tus movimientos, buscando la oportunidad. Veo tu foto en Instagram, no te importa qué dirán, baby. Yo buscándote por ser el que te calienta en las noches, y te quiero ver para resolver. Dime dónde, por favor responde, contéstame, yeah, yeah. Y te quiero ver para resolver. Dime dónde, por favor responde, contéstame. Si necesitas reggaetón, dale, sigue bailando, mami, no pare. Acércate a mi pantalón, dale, vamos a pegarnos como animales. Si necesitas reggaetón, dale, sigue bailando, mami, no pare. Acércate a mi pantalón, dale, vamos a pegarnos como animales. Ay, muévete a mi ritmo, siente magnetismo, tu cadera es la mía, boom, hacen un sismo. Ahora da lo mismo el amor y el turismo, que viene con romanticismo. Si te dan ganas de bailar, pues dale, en esta disco todos somos iguales. Te ves bonita con tu swing salvaje, sigue bailando, ¿qué paso te trae? Si te dan ganas de bailar, pues dale, en este disco todos somos iguales. Te ves bonita con tu swing salvaje, sigue bailando, ¿qué paso te trae? Conmigo, pa, 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 ¿cómo? Si necesitas reggaetón, dale, sigue bailando, mami, no pare. Acércate a mi pantalón, dale, vamos a pegarnos como animales. Sí, señor, que yo ando aquí bien con mis hermanos, orgulloso de ser un hispano. Sí, señor, así es como es, mi nombre es J Balvin, man. Sí, señor, que esta es la meta, espero que esta noche no suene la trompeta. Tú sabes cómo es que es el negocio, improvisando tú sabes todo mi socio. Qué orgulloso me siento de ser latino, cada día somos más finos.
porque somos como el vino. Entre más viejo, pues siempre somos más finos. Hey, tú sabes cómo es que es. Mi nombre es J Balvin, man, y yo sigo aquí improvisando. Aquí en Estados Unidos la sigo montando. Si necesitas reggaetón, dale. Sigue bailando, mami, no pare. Acércate a mi pantalón, dale. Vamos a pegarnos como animales. Tú sabes que no quiero perderte. Tú sabes que este amor es tan fuerte. Era envidia de lo de los dos. Yeah, yeah. Es que esta noche ya saldré a buscarte. Cuando la luna deje de mirarte y me entregues todo tu cuerpo.
Gracias.
Our next honoree takes a fresh look on what it means to be healthy. Her dream is to influence a whole new generation of young women to think beyond losing just a few pounds, and instead, to love themselves with every ounce in their bodies. Let's take a look at this extraordinary young woman.
Masi Arias' audacity to dream of a better life and to change the lives of millions began in the streets of Queens, New York, as an immigrant from the Dominican Republic. With issues surrounding her lack of English, self-image, an emotionally abusive relationship, and her brother's tumultuous battle with cancer, Arias fell into a deep depression. After multiple attempts with other forms of treatment, she turned to exercise and nutrition. And in just 2 years, Arias went from rock bottom to becoming one of the most influential fitness and wellness instructors in America. With an emotionally transparent approach to social media and over 2 million followers on Instagram, Arias ignited a movement for women of all shapes and sizes to love who they are. With as many as 2 out of every 5 Hispanic children classified as overweight or obese, Arias insists on changing that statistic and using her image, her influence, and her commitment to wellness to leave this world better than she found it.
At Target, corporate social responsibility is a company-wide strategy designed to fuel Target's growth, improve people's lives, and help make a sustainable difference in the world. We know wellness is important to our guests, so we've evolved our corporate social responsibility giving strategy to focus on overcoming the barriers to wellness and help make the healthier choice the easier choice for our guests and our communities. We're excited to be investing more than $40 million this year to programs and partners who are committed to increasing the consumption of healthy food and increasing physical activity for kids and families across the country.
Please help me welcome our next presenters. One is an ALMA Award-nominated film and television star, and the other is a rising film director and screenwriter. Please welcome two amazing women, actress Alex Meneses and writer-director Carmen Marrón.
Good evening, everyone. And by the way, I would love to point out Carmen's dress is designed by Latino designer Mario de la Torre.
Yes.
It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
Me, I like to mix my dresses with a little bit of piñata. Masi's commitment to the betterment of our collective health is amazing. I've known myself many fitness gurus in my time, but Masi's approach is second to none. She has made physical fitness more than just an aesthetic change. She's inspired millions across the globe to change their entire mindset. Mm-hmm.
Physical fitness is the foundation for so much more. From it comes mental strength, self-awareness, empowerment, and confidence. There is no one more committed to this cause, nor anyone who so earnestly practices what she teaches.
It is our pleasure to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Wellness Award to recipient Masi Arias.
Thank you.
right. I am so honored. And I want to thank the Hispanic Heritage Foundation for this amazing opportunity and this award. I could only say that I'm extremely, extremely humbled. I want to congratulate all the honorees here. It's amazing to be, you know, sitting in this crowd. And, oh my God, what can I say? My commitment to health and wellness is 100%, okay? So this has inspired me to continue doing more and pushing the envelope to help my Latino community, my fellow Dominicans. Thank you so much. And you know, I am going to continue sending a positive message, not only for health and wellness, but for all the young Latinos and Latinas out there. So thank you so much for this award. And I'm just humbled. Thank you. Thank you.
To present this year's Inspira Award, please welcome Guatemalan actor and star of Comedy Central's hit sitcom Broad City, Arturo Castro, and returning to the stage, Becky G.
Hola, 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 buenas noches. Hola, mama. I have to say hola, mama, because I'm afraid of a chancleta just magically appearing out of nowhere.
I know the feeling.
Yeah,
trust
it's
me.
Latino PTSD. Hi. So, in addition to all those who we are honoring this evening, the Hispanic Heritage Foundation would like to extend a special recognition, and it's called the Inspira Award. Now, this recognition is given to a young artist who has been an inspiration to young people everywhere, and that takes the concept of role model.
Yes,
muchas gracias. Role model. Okay. Role model very, very seriously.
He's been nominated for 7 Latin Grammy Awards and is a 19-time Latin Billboard Music Award winner. That's a lot. talk about inspiring audiences. He has a social media following of 47 million people around the world. Now, we know how big the world is, right? Mm-hmm. As last year's Inspira awardee, I am incredibly excited to hand the torch over to this amazing, inspirational artist.
Yes, so it is our pleasure to welcome to the stage our 2016 Inspira awardee, Prince Royce.
Thank you guys so much. Okay. Thank you guys so much. You know, it's always great to get an award for music, but this is extra meaningful because it's honoring inspiration for youth. You know, when I hear the word Inspira or inspire, so much comes to mind. If I'm an inspiration, it's simply because I'm just like so many of our youth in the country that are achieving great things. Whether their dream is music, business, fashion, or politics, it doesn't matter what it is. Can you go a little slower in the teleprompter? Thank you very much. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just messing with you. You know, if you're raised here, go to school here, work hard, stay focused, and never give up. This is, sorry guys, I'm just a little bit excited to be here. You know what? I prepared this very long speech, but I'm not gonna read the teleprompter. You know, I grew up in the South Bronx in a very rough... What's up, South Bronx? I grew up in a very rough neighborhood in the South Bronx, and, you know, my parents came from Dominican Republic. They were undocumented at first, and then became citizens, and they came with that American dream, that dream to really just come to the United States, work hard, and I'm really grateful for what, you know, for what they gave to me and my brothers. They raised us with a lot of love, and we didn't have much, but we had, you know, we had love, we had care, and they taught me and my brothers that we could do anything, and they truly believed in us. And I was working at a cell phone store when a lot of people told me that I was crazy, that I wanted to become a singer. And when they told me that, I worked hard, I saved up money, I made a demo. When record labels told me my music sucked, you know, really, they told me it sucked. I went out and I worked harder and I got my first record deal. And I feel like, Thank you. I feel like my story truly is a story that you can be anything you want to be, no matter what language, no matter what color of skin, no matter where you're from. In a place where I grew up seeing so much negativity, I found that to be, I used it to turn it around and turn it into a positive. And I'm just so grateful. I want to inspire the youth. I think this is an award that's close to my heart because I try every day to really motivate the kids that, you know, just how I did it, anybody can, just how, you know, sometimes you watch TV and you see these celebrities and you think to yourself, well, that's not going to be me. But I really want to inspire everyone to really know that that anything's possible with a lot of hard work. I visited my high school in the Bronx last week. I try to go every year, and usually I tell the kids, I was just like you, or I look at you and I remind, you know, you remind me of me. But after, you know, receiving this award and writing this speech that I didn't really read to you guys, I realized that, you know, what I really should be telling the kids is, you are me, I am you. And it's just a great honor for me to be here tonight representing the Latino community. I hope to continue to represent my culture, Dominican Republic, with this genre, and just Latinos across the world. Thank you guys so much. It's an honor for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pulse nightclub shooting survivor, Tony Marrero.
Thank you so much. Thank you. On June 12th, 2016, my life was forever changed. 49 innocent victims, ages 18 to 50, were taken from us in a senseless and horrific act of violence. But tonight, I do not give power or acknowledgement to it. I give power to those that left this earth too early. The overwhelming number of young Latinos who lost their lives that evening. Daughters, fathers, mothers, brothers, sons, best friends, and colleagues whose futures were taken much too soon. Tonight, we dedicate this evening not only to them, but to all the members of the Latino community we lost this year. We focus on the unconditional love from pouring from all corners of the globe. Let us join together in an act of solidarity to remember, to forgive, and most importantly, to love. Each and every one of us can help one another by being a positive light in this world. Tonight, be the light.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played that pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing.
She drew the hallelujah.
this room and I've walked the floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. Well, I've seen your flag on the marble arch. Our love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a prayer. Stand before the Lord, a song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Time magazine has named our next honoree one of the most influential people in the world in 2016. And when you see the breadth and significance of her work, you will quickly agree that she is more than worthy of this year's STEM award. So please, let's take a look at the remarkable career of this amazing woman.
As president of the University of Texas at El Paso, or UTEP, Dr. Diana Natalicio is a titan among STEM educators in the United States. With a master's in Portuguese and a doctorate in linguistics, Dr. Natalicio began her career at UTEP as an assistant professor and became UTEP's first female president in 1988. Under her leadership, UTEP has become a nationally recognized research and doctoral university in STEM education. From her first day in office, Natalicio envisioned a student body that reflected the Hispanic demographics of El Paso. Today, over 80% of UTEP's 23,000 students are Mexican American, and an additional 5% are from the neighboring Mexican city of Juarez. For her acceptance of Mexican citizens into the university, Natalicio was inducted into the prestigious Orden Mexicana de Águila Azteca, Mexico's highest award for international citizens. Currently sitting on the board of directors for the Hispanic Scholarship Fund, Natalicio remains a steadfast advocate for the advancement of science and technology in the Latino community.
At ExxonMobil, we depend on bright minds of all backgrounds to keep us at the forefront of solving America's toughest energy challenges. It is a strategy that has helped us succeed for decades. We salute Dr. Diana Natalicio for her role in making the University of Texas at El Paso one of the premier institutions for growing generations of Hispanic engineers and helping ExxonMobil achieve our goals. Congratulations to Dr. Natalicio for her outstanding contributions to math and science education.
Here to present the 2016 STEM Award, please welcome a film star, Nicolas Gonzalez. And also welcome the gentleman who wrote Dr. Natalicio's time profile, the Honorable Julian Castro.
San Antonio and Stanford in the house.
That's right. Welcome, Dr. Natalicio.
Put the award on her for God's sake.
Well, wait.
We're going to talk about you for a second.
Let's
We're gonna make sure that we do this properly and that you get your due. So, Dr. Diana Natalicio's inspiring and audacious leadership at the University of Texas at El Paso, UTEP, turned a lauded institution of higher learning into a beacon of hope for a Latino community eager to contribute to society. She continues to level the playing field for her students by implementing smart and effective policies right into the core of UTEP's mission.
It means the world to me to see someone as courageous and influential and intelligent as Dr. Natalicio, working on behalf of all Latinos who dream of success. Her work creates thousands of opportunities in fields that propel our community into the forefront of the 21st century.
Please help us present this award to someone who is making the dreams of so many come true. We're proud to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage STEM Award to Dr. Diana Natalicio.
Thank you so much. I'm overwhelmed. I'm overjoyed to accept this honor on behalf of the University of Texas at El Paso and the 24,000 talented and hardworking students, 80% of whom are Hispanic, who entrust us with their highest aspirations. Education is the key to transforming our students' lives and the quality of life of our Texas-Mexico border region. At UTEP, we share a vision to ensure that whatever their backgrounds, all young people in our region will have the opportunity to attain their full potential. UTEP is proud to receive recognition as a public research university serving a 21st century student demographic. We're the only public research university in the United States with a predominantly Hispanic student population. More than 50% of our 24,000 students are the first in their families to attend college, and nearly 40% of them report a family income of $20,000 or less per year. UTEP's successful transformation has required balancing a highly intentional quest for excellence with a strengthened commitment to access, thereby creating a new higher education model that is not only working in our setting, but attracting widespread respect and emulation. UTEP's origin as Texas School of Mines in 1914 has provided us a strong engineering and science foundation upon which our faculty and our staff have built highly competitive STEM educational programs at bachelor's, master's, and now doctoral levels, and a robust externally funded research portfolio of nearly $320 million in such areas as cybersecurity and defense, biomedical and neurosciences, additive manufacturing, environmental sciences, materials and nanosciences, and engineering. Our students do it all. As a result, UTEP graduates are exceedingly well prepared to pursue successful careers in settings across the United States and beyond, and confidently serve as role models for the value of enhanced diversity in all professions. Go Miners!
Thank you.
What a night so far, right?
Wow.
Our final honoree received her first set of encyclopedias at a young age by her mother, whose fanatical emphasis on education planted seeds of greatness. Decades later, our honoree sits on the highest court in our nation. a Latina who's blossomed into one of the most inspiring leaders of our time. Let's take a look at one fascinating and incredible life.
A graduate of both Princeton University and Yale Law School, Sonia Sotomayor began her career in the trenches of justice, serving as an assistant district attorney in the borough of Manhattan and serving on the board of directors of the Puerto Rican Legal Defense and Education Fund. Her work led to her appointment as a U.S. District Court judge for the Southern District of New York City, and later as judge on the U.S. Second Circuit Court of Appeals. Sotomayor was an easy choice for President Barack Obama to nominate to the Supreme Court. And in 2009, Sonia Sotomayor became the first Latina Supreme Court Justice in U.S. history. Since her appointment, Sotomayor has served the court with integrity and honor. Sonia Sotomayor carries her vibrant Hispanic heritage pridefully in her soul, a characteristic she calls an ember that blazes forever.
To present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Leadership Award, please welcome the Associate Judge of the New York Court of Appeals, Judge Jenny Rivera, and this year's Inspira Award recipient, Prince Royce.
Buenas noches. During my clerkship with Her Honor, I quickly learned why Justice Sonia Sotomayor has a reputation as an extraordinary leader. She bears all the characteristics of a truly remarkable human being, and by example, shows us what can be accomplished during a life dedicated to meaning and purpose. As her brilliant career illustrates, she is an incredible representative of justice. She is quick, and no one escapes those pointed questions in the courtroom. Thoughtful and compassionate, with an unwavering commitment to the rule of law and the fair and just treatment of all. Her life, as depicted in her book, has inspired legions of young people to follow their dreams and reach for the stars. And she is beloved, absolutely beloved, for the way she handles everything with grace and humanity and humility. But most importantly, because every person matters, no one is unimportant, and no life is meaningless to Justice Sotomayor.
Beautiful words. Justice Sotomayor credits her mother with being her life inspiration. I believe I speak for all of us that the justice has been and continues to be an inspiration to all of us. And I can't help but give a big shout out to the South Bronx, which the justice and I will always call our home.
It is now our honor to present the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Leadership Award to our one and only Justice Sonia Sotomayor.
Eso sí soy, Boricua. Jenny, you almost made me cry. You have to know that every judge is incredibly proud of their former and current law clerks and their accomplishments. Jenny Rivera, who you just heard, was one of my first law clerks. She started with me in my second year as a district court judge. She is now on the highest court of New York State. That's a legacy worth having, isn't it? Jenny, thank you for those warm words, and most importantly, for being a part of my life. Prince Royce, mommy told me that I had to tell you that she loves you. Mommy cumplí. Receiving this award just touches my heart. I am deeply honored and humbled to be part of this illustrious group of talented and extraordinary recipients. My fellow honorees inspire all of us to do more, and I am in awe of each of you. It is particularly touching for me to be honored by a room full of Latino and Latina leaders. To me, leadership means service. Public service has been the keystone of my own life. It became that through the example set by my family, particularly my mother, Celina, and mi abuelita, Mercedes. My mom and abuelita taught me not only the importance of my Spanish heritage and traditions, but they also showed me by example how critical it is to devote one's life to caring for others. And so this award is not about me. It is about the many mothers and fathers, abuelos y abuelitas, and all the others who have led our community, who have taught us all and carried us upward on their backs with hard work and determination. In honoring me and the other recipients tonight, we honor everyone who selflessly gives of themselves each day in big and small ways to better our community. You here in this audience, you here at home, you are the real leaders. Thank you all. Con amor y cariño. Mami, esto eres tuyo. Y le va a encantar, porque le encanta la joyería. Thank you all.
This is our first ever hosting. I don't think we did that bad. What do you think? A couple moments.
Here and there, little bobbles.
Slip of the tongue.
Maybe Cesar and Aleida can get together soon.
Or not.
Anyway, folks, it's been an incredible evening. And our congratulations to all the honorees, of course, each of them who have they have each taken the mantle of leadership or a cause on behalf of others, of course, and have created new expressions of culture through the arts.
As the night comes to an end, let us take a moment to acknowledge Maestro Luke Frazier and the incredible American Pops Orchestra.
It has been a fabulous evening, people.
Yes.
Celebrating our Hispanic heritage.
Yes.
This is a gift to our eclectic and diverse, as proven tonight.
Yes.
Incredibly impactful community.
We come together united by our many flags. Dozens of nations, one outstanding community.
So on behalf of the Hispanic Heritage Foundation and all of us here tonight, thank you for joining us. And now, to cap this little thing off.
Little. This magnificent evening, you mean?
Yes, this magnificent evening. Let's welcome back to the stage
Fania All-Stars!
give you a hand. Come on. Yeah.
Escuchan mi tambor y arman su pareja y se ponen a bailar.